Hey there, viewers. Heart attack, pulmonary embolism, and stroke all have something in common. Can you guess what it is? They occur in different parts of the body, but all for the same reason, a blood clot. Wondering what exactly a blood clot is? Well, today, we'll be talking about all of that. What causes blood clots? Why are they so deadly? How many types of blood clots are there? When should you see a doctor? We'll discuss all of these and more. Why are blood clots so dangerous? A blood clot is one of the most dangerous things that can happen to your body. According to experts, one person dies due to a blood clot every 6 minutes. That's how deadly it can be. The reason they're so deadly is because they can stop the blood from flowing to vital organs. When that happens, your organs will not receive the oxygen they need to function, causing them to fail. Organs like the lungs and heart start failing within 4 minutes of losing blood flow. Exercising daily can help maintain healthy blood flow. Do you exercise daily? What's your favorite go-to exercise? Share your preferences with the Bestie community in the comments below. What causes blood clots? You may be wondering what exactly a blood clot is. While your blood is mostly in liquid form, the clot is a gel-like clump. A blood clot can be useful when you have a cut or injuries that result in bleeding. These blood clots will block the blood vessel that has been damaged and stop you from bleeding. But when blood clots form inside your body without any reason and end up blocking your blood vessels, it's known as thrombosis. These can move quickly to other parts of your body. When they move to the lungs, they cause pulmonary embolisms. If your blood clot finds the heart, you'll probably have a heart attack. If it reaches the brain, a stroke will happen. Looking for answers on all the latest health and wellness news? Hit that subscribe button and join our millions of followers. Stay up to date on all of our great Bestie content. Types of blood clots. Your blood gets help from a circulatory system that allows it to reach all parts of your body. This system is made up of arteries and veins. The arteries take oxygen-rich blood from the heart to other parts of your body. The veins return the blood from parts of the body to the heart. This gets it reoxygenated. Since there are two types of vessels that carry blood, it's only natural that there would be two types of blood clots. Arterial clots happen in the arteries, and venous clots in the veins. You can also classify blood clots based on their movement. For instance, some blood clots stay in one place, forming inside the vein or artery. This type of blood clot is called thrombosis. Other blood clots travel from one part of the body to the other. This kind of clot is called an embolus. Let's talk about the arterial and venous blood clots in greater detail. Number 1. Arterial clot. Also known as an arterial embolism, this particular clot is most common in the hands and feet. It also blocks the blood flow to various parts of your body. The intensity of your symptom will depend on the size of your blood clot. Depending on how much blood they're blocking, the symptoms can show up very rapidly or very slowly. Sometimes you may not even have symptoms. But there are certain signs you can look out for. One sign is a cold limb. If your arm or leg is colder than the rest of the body, it could be because there's no blood flow. If there's a decrease in your pulse rate or no pulse in your arm or leg at all, it can be a sign of a clot. It's the same thing if you're unable to move your limbs. You may also feel weakness in the same area. Another symptom of a clot is the severe amount of pain you feel. The color of your arm or leg may turn pale. You may also feel a bit of numbness and tingling. If the blood clot has remained longer than expected, there are other symptoms that may show up. Blisters may appear on the skin around the affected artery. You may also see skin shedding and erosion. Necrosis is another possibility. This is when your tissue isn't getting the proper amount of blood flow and starts to die. If the blood clot has occurred around an organ, the symptoms depend on which one of them has been affected. The general symptoms to look for are pain in the particular area and decreased function of the affected organ. Before we move ahead, here's another video you might like. Blood clots are dangerous. So are other bodily changes you're brushing off. Watch and learn about 10 body changes that need your immediate attention. Now back to our discussion on blood clots. Number 2. Venous clot. Clots that form in your veins can build up over a period of time. One of the more serious types is deep vein thrombosis, or DVT. In DVT, the clots occur in a much deeper vein. This is compared to the other forms, when your surface veins are affected. The DVT clot can happen in your lower leg, thigh, and pelvis. But sometimes you'll even find it in your arm. The deadliest part of a DVT is when the clog dislodges itself and goes through the bloodstream into the lungs. When that happens, you suffer a pulmonary embolism, which stops the blood from reaching the lungs. This can result in death. DVT, however, does not cause a stroke or heart attack, according to experts. General symptoms for DVT include swelling and pain in the affected area. You'll also feel tenderness and see red skin. If you suffer from pulmonary embolism, the symptoms include shortness of breath and irregular heartbeat. You'll feel chest pains when you breathe deeply or cough. Very low blood pressure and lightheadedness are some other symptoms. The other serious venous clot is cerebral venous sinus thrombosis, or CVST. This happens in the brain's venous sinuses. This particular clot keeps the blood from draining out of the brain. This can cause the blood to leak into the brain's tissues. Symptoms of CVST you need to look out for include headache and blurred vision. You might even suffer a loss of consciousness. Seizures are also one of the symptoms. This is where you lose control of your body's movements. The more serious cases could result in a coma. When should you see your doctor? When it comes to blood clots, it comes down to the timing. As soon as you see any of the symptoms listed, you should get yourself a checkup. In fact, don't even bother calling your doctor and waiting for a response. Get yourself to a hospital ASAP. Your cells will start to die within 4 minutes from a lack of blood circulation. If you have a stroke, the sooner the clot is identified, the smaller the chance of severe brain damage. It's very important you don't brush off the symptoms. If you're having even the smallest suspicion that something might be a clot, get medical attention. You just got a 101 class on the dangers of blood clots. It's so important for you to have proper blood circulation. In fact, good blood circulation is like an antidote for clot formation. Would you like to learn more about the causes for poor blood circulation? Can you improve blood circulation naturally? Here's what you need to know. Watch 5 causes of poor blood circulation. You can also try our video on 20 proven tips for improving blood circulation. Go ahead and click one, or better yet, watch both and learn more about health and fitness. Did you know about the dangers of blood clots before watching this video? Let us know in the comments below.